The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Kevin in Orlando. Hey, Kevin, what's going on?
Hey, I'm doing great. You know, I am addicted to TFNN.
We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. It's a great network, man. And I want to thank everyone out there, you know, for making it a great network.
Well, it's great because I do outside sales, so I get to have the station on my phone the whole day. And when I go pick up the kids at from school at 3 o'clock, they all love and give them the old rail. Educating the kids at a young age is a good thing.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks, and a great week. To begin a great relationship, know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are, what the needs of your mind are, what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women. Some will make a good match for you and others won't. The two of you only need to be like a key to lock, a match that works. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 112, NASDAQ up 41, S&P's up 14, gold contract down $4.60, traded at $1,353 an ounce. Silver up 21 cents at $20.31 an ounce. Platinum up $3 at $1,099 an ounce. Copper up 2.5 pennies at $2.14 a pound. Light sweet crude off 84 cents, trading at $44.57 a barrel. Bonds, you get the 10-year note, down 20 ticks, 133.05. 30-year bond off a full point, 7 ticks, 175.23. King dollar up 263 ticks at 96.50. The euro is trading at $1.10, and the yen is at 102.76. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? S&Ps today, we hit 2143. What did 2143 do? 2143 takes out the high of 2015, which is 2134.72. We've hit 2143 thus far. Dow Industrials, what do we have with the Dow? Dow Industrials are trading up $113. You're at 18,260. What I expect you're going to see here, we're right next to the also the highs of the May 2015, which is 18,351. You get this close to them, the S&P took it out. I expect we're going to see a failure in the S&P, but the S&P took it out. The Dow wants to get up into that 18,351. We'll see whether they get juice when it's up there. You're only about 100 points away from not even 100 points right now. I expect that's going to tag it the next couple of days. That being said, now let's watch how this shakes out. You go to the NASDAQ. What do we have at the NASDAQ? NASDAQ today is up $41. You're at 49.98. The NASDAQ, folks, is just coming into its downdraft from January of this year. The exact number, which is pretty cool, of the gap down from December to January is 4,999. We're at 4,998.81. Bottom line, you know, we'll see whether it can get into up into that level. I expect it's not going to get to its high. That's the high is another 5,230 points. Just the swing point. The next swing on the NASDAQ is 176 points. I don't see it getting up there. Russell 2000 coming how far it's off its high is even more dramatic. Now, the NASDAQ and the NASDAQ composite are the weakest. The Russell 2000 is at 1191. The difference is this, is that off its high, it's way off its high. We're at 1191, 1295 is the high that was generated out here in June of 2015. The difference is that the small caps did go higher, had a bigger retracement. The small caps made it through its January downdraft of this year. That was 1139, and we're at 1191. So the small caps look like they want to go after the 1205. And that is the differential and the aspect of the small caps are stronger than the NDX 100 as well as the NASDAQ composite. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold contract is trading at 1354. What it has done is this. We had the monster sign of strength on June 24th. Gold went from 1252 to 1362. Huge price spread, huge volume, all of the above. We went back up and we tested that on the 6th of July. We got to 1377 and we closed above it. Then what do? Last Friday, you get below it. Now watch this. On the 6th, we got over it with 237,000 contracts. We were dealing with 574,000. And there's no way, by the way, that you can go up for Everwood volume or down for Everwood volume. At some point, especially when you have huge signs of strength, what you see is you have the huge sign of strength, market goes forward, or market croaks, goes down the other way. First time up, most of the time you get a failure on price, failure on volume. The kicker here is, how do you back down from that level? Well, when we got over the level with 237,000. On Friday, you came back with 300,000 and it held price. That being said, the 1336 right now is game that this contract wants to go at least test. What I expect you're actually gonna see here is that we're gonna be down somewhere in about the 1282 area. Why? Well, silver. Silver, folks, you talk about volatility, silver has volatility in spades. Silver's up 23 cents. We're trading at $20.33. What silver has done is this. When we bring silver back from the April 1st timeframe, the A to B, C to D structure had an expansion that did over a 1 to 1.618 on a daily basis. That is a problem that sets up an automatic change of trend, and we'll see how this shakes out. Well, we have silver out here today. Silver got to $20.76. You're at $20.33. We'll see how it comes off that level. But that my take is that what you're going to see is that the silver contract is going to come down hot and hairy, heavy. And what's going to cause it? If we go over to the dollar, well, it looks the dollar index right now is hanging at these highs. Now, the dollar index, just as gold, just as the bonds, I'll do the bonds in a second. The spike that occurred on the 24th is a huge one. The dollar index is laying right underneath that. It's 96.70. Now, we did 66,000 contracts. I don't expect that you're going to have the contract value, meaning higher, when you get over that level. What I do expect you're going to see is that the dollar index wants to test the 98.91 level. That was the downdraft of the 3rd of February, as well as it tried to get higher once again on March 10th, and it got to 98.50. So I do expect you're going to see that contract move its way up into that level. Good old the bonds. Okay, so check it out. The bonds right now, folks, the 10-year's down 20 ticks. We are at 133.05. This also wants to go test the lows that were established out here last Friday. That is 133. You're right next to it, actually. 133.01. It's making its way down there. What I do expect you're going to see is that you're going to see at least a test. We'll see where it holds. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow up 117. You get the NASDAQ up 43. S&Ps are up 15, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the first hour. We have our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes. Now, don't forget, folks, every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time, Steve has a great show right here at TFNN. And no matter where you are right now listening in your car, remember that you can get us right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com on your browser, hit Tiger TV. You're going to get great HD video as well as audio. You can also come over to our website at TFNN. You can test drive Steve's newsletter 30 days absolutely free. The way you do this, you go to TFNN, you go to newsletters, you go to trading newsletters, you'll see the Master in Probability. You can test drive this right here, right now, 30 days absolutely free. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, how you doing? Welcome back, Tom.
Thanks, man. Great to be back. It's nothing like a little vacation.
Yeah. And always, some nice market movement. Pretty interesting with the S&P being able to take out its high. I heard you earlier talk about, that you think the Dow was going to attempt to do the same thing.
Yes.
And that's music to my ears and those of Mastering Probability subscribers. So what I thought that I would do today is be able to walk listeners and viewers through the logic and the reasons why subscribers and I went long, 100% long, the market back on June the 28th out there.
Okay.
And so what I'm going to start with, for those that are watching us on Tiger TV, and just lay out some of the reasons why. Now, this chart that we're looking at here, the top portion of it is the annual seasonal pattern of the Dow. And the annual seasonal pattern of the Dow, typically the Dow forms a bottom sometime at the end of January, early February, which in essence is what occurred this year after a nice decline during that month of January. If we take us to where we were at, and to me, I kept looking at this Brexit thing saying, is this real? Is this really going to happen? Not the Brexit thing, but is the market really going to move down into June 24th? Well, that whole Brexit thing was June 24th. Now, this seasonal portion of the chart we're looking at, the top portion, is the cycle over the last 84 years. And over the last 84 years, it's basically about June 24th when the market forms a bottom. Now, the bottom panel of the chart, Tom, is we happen to be in, a presidential cycle. This chart here represents the the fourth year of a second term president. And it also, and it uses different data because, but it also identifies a bottom that should form sometime around June 24th to the July 1st timeframe. So I knew that based on cycle pattern that we had the potential of a bottom. But it was only the potential of the bottom. We needed other signals. So what I did was, on that June 24th, on that Friday when we had the Brexit, what was interesting to me was this chart here, which is the weekly chart of the FTSE.
Okay.
And when the weekly chart, when everything was said and done, you know, you talk about the market being able to squawk, walk, and talk and looking at swing points. I like to see the market squawk, walk, and talk by utilizing Japanese candlestick pattern. And when we take a look at the actual candle that formed the week of June 24th, it was actually a bullish candle. And so I was scratching my head saying, okay, well, we've got the seasonal pattern that says we should maybe making a low. The way that the FTSE responded, it actually was defending its lows out here. And that was actually a bullish engulfing that it formed. So then I went back and took a look at the daily chart for the FTSE. And with the daily chart, what that June 24th move to the downside when our S&P futures went limit down, what the FTSE was also doing was testing one of my favorite candles, which is a nice little hammer candle. But it was more than just a hammer candle. That's where the red line is going across the bottom of my screen. It was more than a hammer candle because what it really was a 0.618 Gartley buy. You see, Tom, when that hammer candle formed out here in June inside of the FTSE, it had completed a 1-1 A to B equals CD to the downside, and it was a 0.618 retracement off of its lows from February. And it was the first A to B equals CD to the downside. So it actually gave a very nice buy signal out here. Then that says, okay, you know, what do we do? So I knew we were looking for, so putting all that together, I knew that we were looking for a bottom in our market. Now, this chart here, I'll get back to that bottoming pattern. But with regard to what the FTSE is doing, a Gartley pattern, I'll go back to this chart slide right here. A Gartley pattern has five basic outcomes. It's some type of retracement of that A to D leg, which is either going to be 0.382 or 0.618 or 0.786 or that 100% move of a move that you need to patent that term, I think, out there. And it's done more than that. The fifth outcome is where the Gartley buy actually forms a brand new C point, which is what it did down here during that Brexit. Now, what's interesting with regard to where the FTSE is at right now, it's on its way to completing at least the 1-to-1 A to B equals CD to the upside. So we ought to see the FTSE get up into the 6,700-ish area. 6,716 is the 1-to-1 projection. But the way that price has exploded off of this C point really suggests that the FTSE could make a run for 69.68. So whatever the Brexit thing was supposed to do, it's not showing its head inside of the FTSE. Now, I don't know what the volume characteristics look like, and maybe you can update us on that with regard to the FTSE. But at the same time that the FTSE was making a Gartley buy, so too was the NDX 100. And the NDX 100 on that June 28th day was when we had a nice little bull sash candle. This was also about a 1 to 1.272 A to B equals CD. It was a 0.618 Gartley buy pattern. It hasn't taken out the highs like the FTSE has. But that is still a possibility. Now, there are a couple other things that occurred on June 24th that were signals that the market was forming a bottom. And one of those signals was that the New York Stock Exchange on that day of June 24th had a greater than 10-to-1 down day volume versus up day volume. And typically on this chart here, I show you some of the other examples. That is the bottom of my screen, that red horizontal line. Okay. Anything above that happens to be one of those big flush outs to the downside, exhaustion move, in this case, to the downside. And that took place on June 24th and said, okay, we ought to be looking for a bottom. There was another thing that happened. Now, I know you have for significant, real significant bottoms. I know that you take a look at the trend, a 5-day reading greater than sum of, I think it's maybe 10 or something. I don't recall the exact number off the top of my head, but there's also another way that we can use the trend when we use it in conjunction with 1-day moves inside of the VIX index. And on June 24th, we saw about a 40% increase inside the VIX index, and we had the trend index close above 2. The combination of both of those was also saying, look for a bottom, look for a bottom. And that's exactly what we did. Then we went to these shorter term charts, and they show one of my favorite patterns. These are 30-minute charts here for both the ES and the NQ. This is where price moves lower, does with less relative energy, gives us nice bullish reversal signal out here, and then it starts its ascent higher. Now, that was the ES and the NQ. We also had the exact same thing take place inside of the Dow, where we've got that red Red Arrow. And those were the reasons that my clients and I went long the Dow. We went long another index inside of the NASDAQ, and we took a we went long a stock inside of the semiconductor index. Question, where is the Dow headed now? Well, I agree with you. It's going to go back and test its highs. It's going to probably get to the, it's going to spike the 18,285-ish level. If it gets above 18,285, we could see the Dow move up to 18,593, and that's the top of its horizontal trading range. So that's why we took a long position inside the Dow and wanted to share that with all the viewers and listeners out there.
It's a beautiful thing, man. Totally.
You betcha.
Listen, folks, come over to our website at TFNN, hit newsletters, trading newsletters. You can test drive Mastering Probability right here, right now. And, of course, don't forget, every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time, you can listen to Steve right on your cell phone, TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. Thanks, Steve. Have a great
you
one,
bet.
Man.
Take care, Tom.
Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, many commodities are trading at relative lows. And now you can take advantage with EverBank's new limited-time, 5-year, market-safe currency comeback CD. This indexed and U.S. dollar-denominated CD offers 100% principal protection and is based on the equally weighted performance of currencies of Australia, Canada, Chile, Mexico, and South Africa. These five countries are especially rich in commodities, and their respective currencies are poised to do well should commodity prices begin to recover. Keep in mind that no APY, or periodic rate of interest, is paid on the CD. Don't miss out on this innovative new financial opportunity. CDs must be opened and funded by the upcoming July 14th deadline. To apply online and learn more about the CD, including product terms and disclosures, visit everbank.com/TFNN now. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over and take a look at Alcoa. We're at the beginning of the earnings season once again, folks. Alcoa is going to be kicking it off after the close out here today. Alcoa right now is trading at $10.04. Up 21 cents. And if we take a look at this, you know, this is it's amazing that this stock actually kicks off earnings. I mean, it's been a dog for so long, it's pretty incredible. I mean, you bring this back, was trading at $48. 2007 crashes down to $4.97. Does a counter trend bounce up to $16 and you're laying out at $10. You know, that being said, So right now we're $10.03. And let me put this a little bit closer. So I put this on a weekly. Yeah, what we have here is this. Okay, so check this out. This is going to be wild watching this thing shake out. Okay, so at $10.03. At $10.03, what you have, as I expect, you're going to see this thing back off after the earnings here tonight. Why? Well, what it did is it got into the lows of the high from the week of April 29th. And it has zero juice going into them. We were going into it with the 89 million versus 161 million. So what's going to be intriguing in this particular one is this. What happens with aluminum, folks, is that aluminum, the amount of energy they use to make aluminum is huge. So the oil market, of course, has a big implication as to the fundamental numbers. And if Alcoa can't make money when we go back and we take a look at this oil chart, when oil was down hitting $27, okay, it's going to be pretty intense, man. You know, so yeah, oil has gone from the $27 to the $44, but if we just bring this thing, let's see, so we're talking February, let's see, it's July, April, May, June, July, April, May, June, so it's April. Yeah, they're still dealing with really inexpensive oil prices, $35 to like $45. Let's go to Mike in Toronto. Hey, Michael, what's going on?
Hi, thanks for taking my call.
Sure, how you doing, man?
I think I found a way to sell short Vancouver real estate.
Oh, that'd be interesting.
Yes, ticker symbol EQB on Toronto, the Equitable Bank.
EQB. 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 Let's see. CN. Okay, so that's the Equitable Group. They provide first mortgage finances for properties across Canada. The company specializes in multi-unit residential alternative single-dwelling mortgage financing. Okay, so the low is 43. The high is 63. They pay a 1.5% dividend. Okay, so the reason that Michael was saying that he's looking to short the Vancouver real estate, I suspect, is that this has been, no doubt, a rocket ship on the way up. You know, and the bottom line is that I'd have to do more work on it just on a fundamental basis to see whether, okay, is that the case? But, okay, I see what you're looking at. I like what this is saying here. So this has a high of $72.49, which was December of 2014.
Okay.
Let me see this thing. So put this. Yeah, you have a high volume swing. Oh, interesting. I see what's happening here, though. Okay, so check this out. It's not ready yet, man. So when this thing came down January this year, Michael, okay, it hits, one second. It hits the, it gets to a low of 43.19. The high of that low is 52.48. And what has happened is that as it surged higher in May, as that's coming back down, the highs of that low bar is holding that tight, man. You know, at 52.48.
Okay.
So I wouldn't be shorting that right now.
So the pivot is 52.48.
Yeah, I'm using the high of that low bar on a monthly.
Okay.
And what you want to take into consideration, now this is, you know, there's no doubt that prices in Vancouver, folks, are huge. What you also have happening, though, you got to take into consideration that the Chinese are trying to get rid of their cash as fast as possible. And that's where it's going. A huge amount of it's going. Huge amount of it's going to San Francisco also. But that makes a difference, man. You know, because what you have is that over the course of the last couple of years, it looked like the Chinese were paying huge amounts of money for many hard assets, but in fact, they haven't. You know, it was just like when the Russian guy turned around and bought the New York Knicks. They thought it was big money, but guess what? Compared to how the Russian ruble went down versus what our dollar did, he scored beyond belief. So,
okay.
It's always a perception. Do you know what I mean? But I.
Okay. It's, well, I watch it.
I'm psyched that you, you know, picked this up. So we'll keep an eye on it, man.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Yeah, and you know, as one of the tigers saying, the Chinese are paying cash for the homes. They are. What you want to wrap your head around, folks, is this: is that the easiest thing to wrap your head around is that you have Canada, you have the United States, you have China that's made a fortune, okay, on basically slave labor. They're trying to get the money out as fast as they can get it out, and they want to get it into Canada and the United States. Just totally makes sense. Just picture if you were in a situation out there, you go back 30 or 40 years, you have nothing, you make a big score, what are you going to do? You're going to get the money out, you're going to get the kids out, you're going to get the whole ball of wax out. That's what you have happening. And so the competition level in those cities are going huge. And what does happen is that people can look at it and say, this doesn't make any sense. Well, it doesn't make any sense in the context that if you and I were making dollars, or if you're up in Canada and you're making the Canadian dollar, it absolutely makes sense when you've made huge amounts of money and you just got to get it out. That is what you have happening in Vancouver and in a huge way. It doesn't mean it's not going to crash. At some point, it will. I mean, we saw it happen with the Middle East investors in the 70s and 80s. You saw it happen with the Japanese investors in the 80s. Bottom line, it happens, but I don't see it happening just yet. You know, you're talking about rates that are still, even they don't have, they're paying cash, but you're talking about rates that are still very inexpensive. We are 1.4 on the 10-year right now. And bottom line is that, yeah, the bonds and the notes are pulling back right now. But I don't think they're done going down, going uptown. You know, the notes are pulling back today with 857,000 contracts. You know, that's nothing compared to how we went up with 3.1 million contracts. You know, I do expect these 133.06 on the 10-year. I think 132 is game. And listen, it's possible that we'll get a real pullback. You know, that being said. Cash, there's so much cash that's running around the world right now and with no homes that you can expect more upside in many of these hard assets. We take a look at some of the higher volume stocks in this low volume market, because today, remember something, Mondays, Fridays in the summer, low volume, big time. That being said, though, last Friday had some juice underneath it. Not as much volume as we went down, but it did have juice underneath it. This is Tom O'Brien, this is TFNN. You stay right there, we'll be coming right back. And what we do have coming up the next, at the end of this week too, is you have the financials coming out with numbers, and they look bad, folks. The financials, the financial sector looks like a sick sector. We're gonna be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD.
For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to Amazon and take a look at Amazon. So Amazon, folks, is trading up $7.50. We're at $753. So check this out. This is pretty intense, man. So Amazon just overtook Berkshire Hathaway in a market cap. This is really wild. This is just coming across the tape as I was talking with Michael from Toronto. So Amazon's market cap right now is $355 billion. They take in $134 billion a year, or $35 million a quarter. Berkshire Hathaway has a $354 billion market cap. They take in $221 billion and taking $55 billion a quarter. So that is pretty impressive in the aspect of, number one, what Amazon is all about and where this thing has come from. Pretty amazing, actually. Now, does that say that it's not going to pull back? No, I suspect I wouldn't be short in Amazon, that's for sure. But bottom line is that that is pretty intense, man. You know, it's you know, Amazon, when you take a look at it from 2008, Amazon was trading at $34. So it's gone from $34 up to $755. Wow. And of course, what happens each and every day is that you hit that Amazon button and we're all ordering a lot more. And I expect that he's going to be picking apart a lot of different businesses on a continual basis, because he's really in the delivery distribution business. So it doesn't matter what it is. That's the business that this guy's in, period. I mean, and he does a great job at it. So you can expect more of it. We go take a look at the financials. So financials, XLF. With the XLF is up 15 cents today. Weak dog, big time. We hit today $23.12, where this that level there, $23.11, was the where this thing gapped down from on the 23rd, from the 23rd to the 24th. What is so intriguing here is that the financials are so weak. We go take a look at J.P. Morgan. J.P. Morgan is coming out with its numbers on the 14th. Today, well, that's Thursday. That we're at $62.42. This also got into the gap. The top of the bottom of the gap is 63.53. We hit 62.40.95 today. It looks like it's not even going to be able to make that. It's actually failing at this level, which is pretty amazing, actually, in the context of the market, the S&P's hitting all-time highs. The financials are way off their highs. We're at $62. And the high is $70 inside the XLF. So that's going to create problems right across the board for for the S&P in general. If we go to Goldman Sachs, Goldman Sachs is trading up $1.59. That's coming out with numbers next week. It's coming up the 19th. That also can handle higher price. It's up $1.70 out here today. We're at $152.17. And the high that it's going after is $152.80. What you do have is that the Goldman Sachs continues to lay quite a few people off in New York. What happens in New York, folks, when they're laying jobs off, they have to basically tell their regulator. And every week, it seems like they've been laying off quite a few people off. The number right now this year is up to 400. So that's a big number. Let's go to Frank in Gloucester. Hey, Frank, what's going on, brother?
Tom, how are you? Long time.
I know, man. How you been?
Very good. I thought of you the other day. I had lunch at Sullivan's.
Did ya?
Castle Island.
I love it, man.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that was a hoot.
That is a beautiful thing, man.
Yeah, very, very good. So, anyway, I was telling Tom O'Brien's stories.
Listen, you know, that guy there, so Dan Sullivan, folks, this guy that started Sullivan's, he's an amazing guy. What he used to let me do, I used to have this truck that when I get out of the Marines that I used to run around the city with. And, you know, you might have, may or may not know this, Frank. He gave me that spot. So picture this. This guy is the Monopoly.
Oh, really?
This guy is the Monopoly. He gave me that every winter. When he closed, right, he'd allow me to be there all winter long until he opened back up. Isn't that cool?
I see.
Oh, it was amazing.
That's great.
It was so cool. The guy was an amazing guy. So it's Dan, his son, is my age. Well, actually, a little older than me. And it was the father that I dealt with, though. What a great guy, man. And it's great seeing it now. You know what's so crazy now, folks? Picture this. No matter where I go, almost, that people know South Boston and Sullivan's in general. And you know, listen to this, Frank. This is a crazy story. We were out, Bridget and I were out a couple weeks, about a month ago now, right? And I forget where we were. We were down in Florida somewhere. Someone asked, we're from South Boston. And you know what they said? Oh, my God, that's so beautiful. And I said to Bridget, I never thought I'd hear that in my life. Isn't that crazy?
Well, it is gentrifying a little bit.
No, it's $600 a foot. I know. Sick. It's sick, man. I know, man.
You can't touch those places. Some of my relatives bought a place over there just for investment. So.
Listen, man, I don't even know how they can afford it. But guess what? I saw a house last night. I'm coming home last night. So picture this, folks. Right where I used to, there was also a M Street Park that I used to sell. There was baseball games at night, so I'd be up there every night. Mm. Well, right across the street, there's a six family. It sold for $3 million. $3
million.
$3 million. That's insane. But guess what? It is what it is, right? It's a city now.
It's
a city.
Whatever you can get.
It's whatever you can get, brother.
Yep.
So, Potash Corporation.
Yeah. Potash,
okay.
Is this thing dead or what's...
Let's take a look.
Is it going to have a heartbeat again, do you think?
Yeah, let's take a look. So it's POT. It's Potash Corporation of Saskatchewan. Okay, the low is 14. The high is 29. Yeah, you know, I owned Agrium for a while. Let me just look at Agrium and see what this looks like. We made some decent money on it. I sold it.
What's the symbol on that one?
AGU. This is the strongest one there is. But see, that backed off too, man. These things...
Yeah.
They're not, they're still in a consolidation. So let me pull pot back up. Okay, so the danger here is that it wants to go test that low of January 25th, you know, that's...
Sure.
Yeah. I just let it be for a bit, you know. I like what these look like, but they just don't have enough strength, man.
Okay,
you know?
So just be patient.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, understood.
It's always a pleasure, man.
Thanks, sir. We'll talk to you again.
Thanks, Frank. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. And as our man Duffy is saying in the den, to look at the grains, and there's no doubt. Your corn down 1.9% today. You got wheat off 1%. Let me just go look at this corn market for a second because the grain market, there you go. This is one of the reasons. So corn has just gone from $4.43 a bushel. That was generated out here June 17th. And we're at 3.48. That's a huge problem, folks. That is why these agriculturals can't move. That's corn. Let me go look at wheat. Here's wheat. So 4.30. Yeah, same deal. So the wheat just went from 5.33 down into this 4.15. And yeah, that's. I would say that's one of the main reasons. So evidently at this point, we have lots of corn and lots of wheat. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 85. You get the NASDAQ up 34. S&Ps are up 10. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back. Let's go to our man Carlos in California. Carlos, what's going on, brother?
All right, Tom. Welcome back.
Thanks so much, man. Great to be back.
Oh, yes. I hope you had a very good vacation.
I did. I had a blast. It was awesome. Big time.
Tom, I'm calling regarding the Nikkei.
Yes.
I'm asking for an exit on this one. I am long on pork contract, and I'm sitting on a quite decent profit right now.
Okay, so
I need your opinion.
Let's take a look at it. So the Nikkei did, folks, is this. Okay, you had a low, high volume low established on February 12th, rather. 3.4 billion shares traded. Low there, price was 14,860. Now watch this, folks. It goes from 14,860 all the way up to 17,613. That high was established on the 25th of April. And guess what? All the way back down to that low of 14,864. And it's hard to believe, but it hit it by 1 point when you're talking about a $14,000 number. Now, as it hit with 2.6 billion versus the high volume low of 3.4. So I suspect that's where Carlos probably went long or somewhere on there. What I'd do is this. I'd peel this off tonight. I'd let it open. So you're long the options in the U.S. market or in the futures market?
In the futures market.
Okay. So I suspect what you're going to have is this. You know, last night we got up to 15,816. You closed at 15,700. This will probably try to get over the 15,800 again. And it's coming into this monster downdraft. I just move it out. You know, you should... This can be up another $400 or $500 tonight. Do you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
It's like take the money and run, man, because this is going to come back down again. And where it's going to get some heavy flack, Carlos, is the low of the 28th of April, which is 16,662.
Okay.
You see that level right there? It's over the downdraft, but between the downdraft, and what you have here, folks, is this. This is always cool when you have this, is that you have one downdraft that started on the 28th of April. You went from 17,572 to 16,652. That was in one day. Oh, my God. That's sick. And then you had the next downdraft, you know, which was Brexit, evidently. Yeah, it was the 24th, yeah. Which is... You know, so that level right there, that's where you want to sell it, right inside there, man.
Beautiful. Well, Tom, thank you very much. I really appreciate your help.
Great hearing from you, man.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Let's go to Steve in Connecticut. Hey, Steve, what's going on?
Hey, how you doing? Welcome back.
Thanks so much, man. Great to be back.
All right. I'm looking at RBS. I picked it up right up, you know, when it was pretty low, a little over 4, and I'm watching some movement on this. I've had some calls on this as well.
Okay.
Just see what you think about RBS. I'm not really into this company very much and understanding this financial.
It's a good trade. Yeah, let's take a look at it. So you get RBS, folks. The low for the year is 391, which is established on the 6th of July. We're trading at 471 right now. So this equity got, you know, toasted and roasted. Went down from 750 on the 23rd and got into 391. Let me bring this all the way back, because I think I remember this. This was testing the low out here all the way back in 2008, I think. So 286 was the low, 24.4 million. Yeah, it tested it way too much volume, so that means it's going to be back there. Yeah, I'd be careful, man. I'd be taking some bread, man. Yeah. You know what it looks like, Steve? I think you probably can wait till tomorrow morning.
Yep.
You know, but I'd take the bread before our banks start reporting, and they start reporting Thursday, man.
So Thursday, our financials will get hit.
They do. So I think you get 490 out of it probably, man.
We'll see, yeah.
Cooking, brother. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Alex in Newton. Hey, Alex, what's going on, brother?
Hi, Tom. How are you doing?
You're doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good, man.
Subscribe for your gold report. I've been following you for a while. The first time I subscribed for it. And what I love about your gold report is that you give us a direction. You give us an overview of the whole market, and you leave final decision to us because you give a lot of ideas. After that, you can choose whatever you want to follow, whatever you don't.
Yeah.
That is great.
Okay, brother.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Thanks.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Proceed with the eyes of love. If you have the eyes of love, you see love wherever you go. The trees are made with love. The animals are made with love. Everything is made with love. When you proceed with the eyes of love, You see God everywhere. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials up 80, NASDAQ up 31, S&P's up 950, gold contract down $2.50, trading at $1,355 an ounce. Silver up 26 cents at $20.36 an ounce. Platinum up $4 at $1,100 an ounce. Copper up 2.5 pennies at $2.14 a pound. Light sweet crude off 98 cents, trading at $44.43 a barrel. Bonds, we had the 10-year note down 21 ticks, 133.05. 30-year bond off a full point and 4 ticks, 175.26. King dollar up 283 ticks, trading at 96.61. The euro is at 110, and the yen is trading at 102. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wonder what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay. So, May of 2015, we broke that on the cash S&P today. We're at 2,137.89. The high that we're talking here that got broken is 2,134. Bottom line, we'll see how long it can hang up here, but that broke. Dow Industrials. The Dow's right underneath it, and I expect what you're going to see. The Dow's going to come up, whack this baby, test it next couple days, more than likely tomorrow. Right now, we're at 18,226. The high we're talking is 18,351. We had hit 18,283 today, backed off slightly. Doesn't have the juice. The volume today is anemic. Volume out here was 800 million versus 931. On the NYSE, it was 1.6 versus 1.9 on the NASDAQ. Bottom line, though, Dow Industrials look to me like it wants to test that high also. That being said, NASDAQ is saying, guess what? S&P can go to highs. Dow Industrial can go to highs. NASDAQ, not even close. What is the NASDAQ doing? The NASDAQ's doing is this, folks. NASDAQ is at 4,988, and you're just into the gap from how we gapped down in January. That gap is 4,999. We hit 5,000. Doesn't look to me like the NASDAQ can handle higher price. And you have two different downdrafts that the NASDAQ's dealing with. Well, all the markets are dealing with. NASDAQ in particular is showing how weak it is. And what the downdraft is this. You have the downdraft that took place almost a year ago, August of 2015. That's when the NASDAQ went from 5,092 to 4,700, as well as the downdraft at the beginning of the year where the NASDAQ went from 5,000 and got to 4,637. So the composite as well as the NDX 100 is having a real tough time right there. If we go over to the Russell 2000, you're going to see the same type of situation. Russell 2000 got over its January downdraft. What's happening now with the Russell, because the Russell had gone to such higher highs, is that that's trying to test the 1205, and I expect that's also going to test it. We're at 1190, but that's coming into the August of 2015 downdraft. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold contract out here today has tested the June 24th swing high, failed on price, failed on volume. What that sets up is I suspect we're going to get down to the 1308 level. We're at 1356. What I expect we're going to actually do is back down to the tops of this consolidation, where it was consolidating from, which is the 1286 level. And what's going to make that happen, folks? It looks to me like it's good old King Dollar. King Dollar, on a short-term basis, this is, but King Dollar is trading at 96.61. The high of the 24th is 96.70. This thing is laying right underneath that level. Now, it has not had the volume as it's pushing up there. You know, when it pushed up there on the 24th, it had the volume. We had some decent volume come in on the 6th of July. We did 31,000 contracts. Then we did another 30,000 on last Friday. It's just laying here today with light volume. But the way it's laying here, you know, when you stay next to a swing point, you know, for a longer period of time, your probability gets higher that you can jump the swing point. And I suspect we're going to jump it, and we're going to go up and test the downdrafts that had been created out here on February 3rd, as well as March 10th. That number that I suspect the dollar wants to get into is the 98.91 number. Silver contract out here did more than a 1 to 1.618 on the ABC on the way up. Huge run, great run. Bottom line is that you don't like to see a extension more than a 1 to 1.618. Why? Because you have the probability is very high of immediate change of trend, and that's exactly what I suspect we're going to get. What the silver contract did out here today, it failed on price, failed on volume. Silver's trading at 20.36, and first leg down, probably 1928. That was the low that was established on Friday. We'll see how it handles that level. Silver, highly volatile, big time. Bonds. What do we have at the bond market? Okay, so right now, your 10-year is 1.43. So bottom line, need a mortgage, need money, go get it. Still very inexpensive. We take a look at the actual 10-year note. The note is at 133.05. What the note is doing is going down and testing the high volume swing low that was established out here last Friday when the jobs number came out. That's 133.01. Now, we got down here, folks. It made its way down here all day long. The 10-year started out today at 133.28. So this is quite a move for the 10-year. You know, the 30-year can move in 1-point increments. The 10-year normally doesn't. So it's real possible that we'll see this 10-year just jump this 133.01 level. And in fact, if that's what you get, what you're going to see, and this is a pullback on light volume, but if we do get that, what you'll see is that this 10-year can get down and into the low that was established out here on the 30th of June, which is 132.14. We go to the 30-year bond. We take a look at the 30-year. 30-year also making its way down into that lower swing point from Friday. The lowest swing point from Friday on the 30-year is at 175.01. You're at 175.26 right now. Bottom line, those bonds right now are doing a retracement. The volume is lighter. You know, we'll see whether that volume stays lighter. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials finished up 80, NASDAQ up 31, S&P's up 9.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow finished up 80, NASDAQ up 31, S&P's up 10. Let's go to Jim in Oldsmar. Hey, Jim, what's going on?
Hey, how are you today?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
No problem. Thanks for taking my call.
Sure. So what are we going to look at today?
OLED, Universal Display Corporation.
Okay, let's take a look. So this is a consortium of cooperative industry government at development infrastructure support, the flat panel display infrastructure. The company's partners are developing high resolution, full color, lightweight, excuse me, folks, organic light emitting diodes for screens. Okay, so they're taking in right now. Well, man, this is volatile. Some quarters they're taking $29 million, others quarters they're taking $79 million. Okay, so. Right now, the stock's trading at $69.87. Now, do you own this? Are you looking to buy it? Are we selling it? What are we doing?
Eventually, I wanted to buy it. I thought about buying it a good while back because my background was electronics, and I really like the concept of LEDs instead of LCD TVs and displays for the iPhone and stuff. And
okay.
Because LEDs don't have to have a backlight like a LED TV would. So
I see.
Because they generate their own light emitting diode. So, and you can have flexible too. They can have a flexible screen or a wraparound screen.
Oh,
or,
really? Yeah, I got one of those Samsungs with a wraparound screen, man. I love it.
Yeah,
it's pretty. And what it does, folks, which is pretty cool, is that you can't see it. Well, you can see the light from the side, but you can have your work on the side and you just tap this thing, and everything comes out, which is pretty cool, man. Okay.
Yeah.
So what I'm glad you don't own it just yet, and this is why. So this it was a confirmed ABC up, Jim, which is powerful, okay? The price target, you know, this took out a B point, took it out with volume in May. The price target was like $75, and it hit $73.24. You know, so I suspect it's going to pull back now. So what I would do is just wait. Let me just see this for a second. Yeah, I mean, this is going up on price and volume all over the place here. Yeah. So what you did is this, you know, we took out the $63, took it out that price on the weekly at 5 million shares. It blows it away with 6.8. It goes up to the 73.24. I mean, some patience here. I mean, $57 would be the number on this. And it very well can get back there because that's where it broke out from. It broke out from $56.81, man. That's what they like to do, you know? And the thing that's amazing about it, there'd be absolutely nothing wrong with that equity going back as long as you pull back with lighter volume, man, you know, because it's showing strength. And it reached its price projective. So when that happens, that's a big deal. Oh, look, this is interesting too. Yeah, let this pull back because what I just saw, this actually just took out its April 2011 high. Now watch this, 20 million. Yeah, let this pull back. Okay, so now watch this. What we did, folks, is that we took out the high, its high of April of 2011. Now, you took it out with lighter volume, which presents a shorter-term problem. So you hit the ABC price projection, you took out the high, took it out with lighter volume, and that normally would set up a larger pullback. So if it ends up being a larger pullback, what you'll see is this as you come down. As you come down to the first price projected that I gave you out here, the volume would be too high to buy it. That's what normally would happen. You know, at that $57 level. So just wait for it to come down. If the volume's too high, Don't touch it, because then it will go down to the very, it can get to $40 or something. And then be all over it, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I think it'd be good. There was some report today. It was actually going down a little bit late this afternoon. And there was a report that there's going to be a shortage of organic light emitting diodes, and that the iPhone 8 may okay. not all iPhones might be able to be LED. They may have to limit it to their higher end iPhones or something. So
tell me what the difference is of how this works again.
LEDs are like a transistor, only with a clear top. And what happens is they use chemical processes to make bright colors. And for years, they've had bright red and bright green, but blue was a hard color for them to get good enough to make a TV out of. And they still want a brighter blue than what they're actually getting.
I see.
But the advantages are less power.
Yeah.
So like in an iPhone, you won't lose as much battery life with LEDs over LCD.
Okay.
LCD, like liquid crystal displays, require backlighting.
I see.
An LCD TV has either a plasma tube, like a fluorescent light.
Yeah.
Or they have LEDs. Some of the LCD TVs the last few years have said it's an LED TV, but it's really not. The light for the backlight of the LCD was LEDs.
Okay.
Which are more reliable than plasma.
Yeah, I know. I love the picture in plasma, but over a longer period of time, it burns out, right? That's what they supposedly say. Yeah, right. But the pitch is phenomenal, man. Yeah.
Yeah, and LCD is a little different than a plasma TV. But the thing is, the TVs that use backlighting, like LCD, require either LEDs or plasma, like a fluorescent light, to let the light shine through the liquid crystal display.
Yeah.
And when you can get by with just LEDs, it'll drop the amount of power or watts that will be drawn because of that, and it'll be more reliable, too.
Which is huge for our phones, right? Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a big deal for the phone because it's more versatile and uses a lot less battery power.
Oh, I'm telling you, man, this whole thing with batteries and phones, folks, okay, I think it's one of the wildest things to watch society in general. And when their batteries are going out of the phone of what people do, I mean, it's pretty intense, man.
Plus, you get a brighter, much clearer picture with LEDs over LCDs, too.
You do? Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Awesome, man. We appreciate
Thank
the education,
the
man.
Yeah, thank you for the call.
Thanks so much, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Yeah, the battery power is just amazing. Isn't it? It's just wild watching the whole deal, folks. You don't have battery power in your phone, and it might be the end of the world sometimes. Only kidding, but it seems like it sometimes, that's for sure. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Alcoa just came out with numbers. Let's go take a look at it. Alcoa closed at $10.14. It's trading at $10.52 right now. So let's see where that, the last high is 11.50. The swing point is 10.17. So it's going to go after that swing point. It looks like it's going to take the swing point out. Let's see what they have to say right now. Okay, so there she is. The estimate was 9 cents. They made 15 cents. The revenue, the expected revenue, was $5.2 billion. They made $5.29 billion. Deliveries they expect for 2016 to be flat or up 3%. Bottom line, still a dog. Don't touch the thing. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials finished up 80. NASDAQ up 31. S&P's up 9.5. We're going to be right back.
Today, many commodities are trading at relative lows. And now you can take advantage with EverBank's new limited-time, 5-year, market-safe currency comeback CD. This indexed and U.S. dollar-denominated CD offers 100% principal protection and is based on the equally rated performance of currencies of Australia, Canada, Chile, Mexico, and South Africa. These five countries are especially rich in commodities, and their respective currencies are poised to do well should commodity prices begin to recover. Keep in mind that no APY, a periodic rate of interest, is paid on the CD. Don't miss out on this innovative new financial opportunity. CDs must be opened and funded by the upcoming July 14th deadline. To apply online and learn more about the CD, including product terms and disclosures, visit everbank.com/TFNN now. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to Seagate Technology. So Seagate Technology closed at $24. It's trading $26.58. Don't touch this thing. This has been a dog extraordinaire. You talk about an equity that has gone one way, folks. Okay, this is one of them. It went from $69.40 in December of 2014 down to $18. So what's the news on it? Here you go. They are going to take a charge of $164 million. They're reducing 14% of their jobs. Bummer for a lot of people that are working there. That's 6,500 jobs. They had seen their fourth quarter preliminary numbers come in at $2.34 billion. Now they see a $2.65 billion, so they see more. Coming in, but of course, yeah, you can bring all that in if you are paying out $164 million on charges. That's not expensive. That's just going to be charge-offs, I suspect, for the amount of jobs that they are canning, which is the 6,500 jobs. So you do have it popping 2.5 points. That being said, what you have here just in the last 6 months, we've gone from $37. You're at 26 right now, and 26 is coming into the downdraft that was out there from the 14th of April. 14th of April, a gap down. It closed on the 13th of April at $35, opened on the 14th at $27. That is a monster hit. No two ways about that. If we go over and we take a look at the volume characteristics inside the SPY out here today, what you're going to see, it's anemic. So, you know, the SPY also hit new highs. I believe it hit new highs. It did 72 million shares. Bottom line, you're over the downdraft that had 233 million shares. And let me get this back here. And there she is right there. So 213.78 was the high. We had 64 million shares there at that high, which was on the, let me make sure. Yeah, it looks like the 20th of May of 2015. Now, this is what you want to wrap your head around also is this. You took out, the SPY took out its highs. The SPY also pays a dividend. So that's why you want to watch the cash so much. And the cash took it out also. The expense ratio inside the SPY is also almost 1%. So you can see that correlation is that, yeah, you just took it out, but you actually would be higher if, in fact, it was apples for apples without the expense ratio and without the dividend ratio inside it. But that being said, it doesn't have enough juice. You know, if we go over and we take a look at the IWM, well, let's go inside this first, because let's see if I take, well, we'll go inside the Dow Industrials first, because the Dow is going to be the next one up into those levels. So the strength inside the Dow today, you had Boeing was up 1.5%, Goldman was up 1.2%, Intel 1.1%, American Express 1%. If we take the leader first, Boeing, what you're going to see is that this baby has been in a consolidation going all the way back to April. That consolidation is coming, the top of that consolidation is 134.67. And what you have out there is that's a little high volume spike that hasn't got tested yet. That's going to get tested. You know, that's the way this is set up right now. In fact, I'll put it on a weekly. Yeah, this is pretty cool, man. Okay, so check this out. Now, my take is that Boeing's going to be a sell. And why? Because you have a high volume low at $102 from February. The high of that low is $121. The consolidation that's been in, the top of the consolidation is $137. It's actually $136 to $137. And that would be enough if Boeing just gets a little pop up into that area for the Dow Industrials to try to get up into that high. So we'll see where that shakes out. If we go over to Intel, INTC, let me see when Intel's coming out with numbers, because the numbers started today, folks, and they're going to accelerate as we go through this week, and particularly when they come into next week. Next week, we're going to have big numbers. If we go to Intel, what you're going to see with Intel is this. Intel's up 38 cents. $34, well, guess what? That also is going to go after its high from January, which is $35.59. So this is really cool, shaking this whole thing out, how this is shaking out. The reason being is that Intel is also coming up with dramatically lighter volume. You know, so bottom line, what I expect you'll see there, you'll get up, you'll fail, you'll come right back down the other side again. You know, if you do want to test drive my daily newsletter, Market Insights, you can come over to our website at TFNN. You go to newsletters, go to trading newsletters. You can test drive Market Insights 2 weeks, absolutely free. If you want to test drive the Gold Report, you can go to newsletters, go to investment newsletters. You can test drive that 1 month, absolutely free. As we take a look at these markets, now check this out. This is pretty cool, folks. So across the world, what you have is this. If we go to the FTSE first, the FTSE, of course, that's the UK. UK decided to get out of the European Union. Bottom line is that the FTSE is trading at 66.82. Now, the high in the FTSE is 71.22. You know, we'll see whether it can get up to that level. It looks to me like it's going to make a run to like the 6,800. Doesn't necessarily have to get up into the highs, but it's had a huge run higher, that's for sure. And it did have volume the week of the 30th of June. That being said, check this out. The DAX in Germany, which trades like the NASDAQ, is 20% off its high. Big numbers, man. You're talking about big numbers here. The DAX is at 9,800. The high is 12,360. The DAX doesn't have any juice. It can't handle higher price. Doesn't have the juice. The CAC in France, same situation. The CAC in France is almost 20% off its highs. Also, the CAC in France, The high out here is 52.80, and you're at 42.64. Cat, same type of situation, hanging at its lows. This spells problems, you know, coming into the summertime. The counter trend bounce, you know, we went from 39.55 to 4,200 in 3 weeks. That's not a big number. You know, the big number, there's no doubt, big number was in the FTSE. The rest of these indices just don't have it. We go to, let's go overseas. We go to the Hang Seng. The Hang Seng was up 316 points last night. That little baby had volume. So what we're going to see with the Hang Seng more than likely tonight is it's going to try to make its way up to 21,160, which is still going to be another nice move. It was up $300 last night and be $300 tonight. The Nikkei, NKY, now this has been a disaster. The yen has got so strong that it took the Nikkei south in an incredible way. What the Nikkei was doing was testing, and it tested its February swing low, did it with lighter volume, came right down to the number, by the way, too. You know, the February swing low we're talking about is 14,860. Got back up to 17,600 and came right back down. Now, the Nikkei expect got one more night in it. A little bounce tonight, and then guess what? It's going to build cause for lower prices once again. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. The Dow Industrials finished up 80. NASDAQ up 31. S&P's up 10.5. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finished up 80. You had the NASDAQ up 33. S&Ps were up 10. And as we go over and we take a look at the financials, what you're going to see is that J.P. Morgan, folks, is going to be kicking off. Let's see. So they're kicking. They're on the 14th. So we're talking on Thursday. They're going to be kicking off the banking structure. We are at $62.27. What J.P. Morgan did today, as many of the banks did, they failed on price, failed on volume. So this is really going to be wild watching this the whole thing shake out, because what you do have is that the S&P took its high out. I expect somehow, some way, the Dow is going to get up there and at least test it, you know. And I expect failures on both of them. That's the bottom line. But when the S&P already gets over it, and the Dow is so close to it, it'll test it. The NASDAQ is weak. The small caps are weak. We go over. Now check this out. This is where it gets really wild. So let's go into the oil market. So what we have with oil out here is this. The oil contracts trading 45.27. We're on the September contract. We get 45.27. This contract today, you know, came down, and we had some juice on the way down. You know, we're at 208,000 contracts. What it had done last Thursday is it actually broke its swing with volume. You know, so the swing that it broke was $46.94. When you take a look at that, it's like, okay, man, you know, so that's saying it's a setup to get back into approximately the 44.35 level, and it very well can get down into the $40 level. What does that do? Well, guess what? We go over to the XLE, and the XLE is hung up to these highs, and it's hung up there pretty good. It's, you know, oil has backed off. The XLE hasn't backed off. The XLE is trading right where it's been trading since April 20th. You know, the top of this consolidation is kind of right where it is right now, the 69 level. The bottom of this consolidation is down at the 63.50 level. If we go to ExxonMobil, we'll take a look at the two largest weightings inside it. So ExxonMobil's coming out with its numbers on the 29th of July. Exxon is at its highs. When you take a look at this, what it's doing is actually going into, let's see. Oh, this is interesting. See, so what Exxon had done is this. Exxon had taken out its 2007 highs, which is $95. It stayed over those highs for 3 months, then failed. And if you want to see a failure when you are taking out a longer-term high, go check out Exxon, because this is what it did. It took out the high of $96. That was the high of May of 08. It goes up to 104. And when it gets back inside, so it stayed up there for 2 months. When it gets back inside, what happens is this, folks. When you do a failure, you can't bust them up. Guess what? It's going to bust them down. Well, Exxon went from $104 straight down to $66. That is a monster move. What are we doing again? Well, guess what? We're coming up to, and it's going to try to get up and over again, the $95 level. You know, we haven't hit it yet. We've only hit $94.49. So what you want to be setting up, you want to let Exxon get up there, hit it, and see what happens. You fail that level, that $95, guess what? That's going to put more pressure on the S&P, right? Because ExxonMobil is a big part of it. Now let's go over to Chevron. We take a look at Chevron. You add this baby together. Chevron is at $105.39. We bring this back. See what the heck this is doing. Oh, this is intriguing. Doing the exact same thing. Okay, so what Chevron has done is this. We're at $105.39. The 2008 high is $104.63, so it took it out. Last time it took it out, it made it all the way up to $135, huge number, huge, and then crashed down to $69. Talking about, that's a trip, man. Go down $70 straight down. Okay, so now, what are we doing this time? Same number. On Exxon, actually, the number that you want to keep your eye on, because we just took out the $104.63, you want to keep your eye on the a higher swing, which is 109.94. In both cases, you're coming back up to that level. You're doing it with lighter volume, and that sets up a probability that it's going to fail. Hasn't done it yet, but that sets up that probability. We get over and we take a check this out. So Amazon, folks, yeah, Amazon's still up there. Amazon just overtook Berkshire Hathaway on the market cap basis. Amazon was up almost $8 today. It has a market cap right now of $355 billion versus BRK versus Berkshire Hathaway. And this just happened intraday out here today. Berkshire Hathaway has a market cap of $354 billion. I believe that tomorrow, and this is going to get intriguing to see, tomorrow is Prime Day at Amazon. I think that's when everything you can sign up. I'm not sure you can sign up for free or how the whole thing works. I'm a Prime member, but bottom line, it's a big day for Amazon tomorrow. And, you know, we'll see if, in fact, do not go short Amazon. That's the bottom line. You know, Amazon's been going up for, like, in a huge way. It hasn't, I expect you're going to see lower price, but bottom line, it hasn't failed yet at the 684 level. Amazon is trading 753. It would have to get back inside 684. You know, before it basically, you know, wanted to get the lower price. And Amazon, you know, is an equity that flies high. When it does get smoked, it gets smoked very quickly. Last smoke and it took was from it was January. Yeah, so January we went from $696 down to $474 ASAP. You know, bottom line, retail-wise, Amazon is going to be into just about every business that needs a delivery and needs distribution, because that's the business that they're actually in, delivery and distribution. Let's go over to the XAU and the HUI. So gold, the XAU, the HUI, all of the above. Now, what the XAU and the HUI, they're both in longer-term ABC structures on the way up. That being said, guess what? It's the volume is contracting way too much at these levels. I expect the XAU right now are at the $108 level. I expect that you're going to see a pullback somewhere into the 93 level. If we go look at the HUI, what you're going to see, actually, the HUI did it today, which is intriguing, actually. The HUI tested the 273 level today, had lighter volume, pullback, you know, slightly. But what I do expect you're going to see is that with the gold bugs index, that can get back into the 236 level. If we go over to the silver contract, folks, is the culprit. I expect it's going to be the culprit. Let me put it that way. And what it is that this extension inside silver was awesome on the way up. The actual silver equities led the contract on the way up. Silver equities up 300-500%, some of them. That being said, the contract itself did more than a 1 to 1.618 expansion. When you do that, that's an immediate change of trend, probability-wise, and I expect that's exactly what you're going to see, and silver's going to try to pull back to the $18 level, and right now we're at $20.35. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering four-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over and we take a look at the... we're going to dig a little bit deeper into this oil market. We're going to go over to Transocean, which is RIG. So this here, folks, this is not only an offshore drilling contractor, this is one of the largest contractors in deep water wells. So what we have is we're 1178 out here. The consolidation that's been taking place is between $8 up to this $13 level. And if we bring this back, this also, yeah, this is pretty cool. Okay, so check this out. So this has been bouncing along the bottom, since August of 2015. You have a high volume spike out here at 1348. That was generated on the March of 2016. You came back up, you tried to get into that on June of this year, and then you got into 1284 in July. July 1st, in July. So that's pretty cool. I get this on a weekly. So this level here wants to get hit once again, too. So this in itself will give the S&P a little bit. So what it's also saying is that the oil and gas sector isn't ready just yet to give it up. And that may give the Dow just enough oomph to get up to that high. See, the Dow is going to have to do it pretty quick. The reason being is that when you take a look at the banking sector, you have Bank of America that's coming out on the 18th with the numbers. The banking sector is a sick sector out here, big time too. It wants lower price. So once they start coming out with the numbers, I expect that's going to put more selling pressure on the S&P. The real kicker is going to be what moves the NASDAQ. Now, what I expect is going to move the NASDAQ, one of the largest movers, as usual, is going to be Apple. Apple is coming out with numbers on the 26th of July, and Apple has no buyers. Apple's at $96.98. It failed on price and volume today. You know, Apple had, the last gap down on Apple was established on the 26th of April. 26th of April, Apple closed at $104. Next day, it opened at 95. That's what it was going into today and couldn't handle the top of that, which is 98.71. Apple got to 97.65. You closed at 96.98. You did 23 million shares versus 114 million, as well as 40 million, as well as 29 million. I mean, it doesn't matter what little point I take on Apple. Bottom line is that after an extraordinary run, you know, and that, the thing that's pretty amazing about Apple, actually, is that the run, the high in Apple is May of 2015. So we're a long way away from that right now. Let's go to Rich in Oregon. Hey, Rich, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. Thanks for taking my call.
Sure.
My question is, I've been listening to you today, and should I, I'm a trader, so should I get out of my SLV now?
Silver,
the ETF.
FLV?
No, S is in Sam, LV.
Oh, I got it.
Silver,
I would.
ETF.
Yeah, I would. The iShares Silver Trust, you're at $19.30. Yeah, it's extended, man. You know, so watch this here. Your A point on this is $14. It was established the 1st of April. Your B point is 17. You get $3. Your C is 15, and it extended itself way too much. It got up to 1945. Take the money and run, man.
Cooking, okay,
brother.
Appreciate it, Tom.
Have a great one. Have a safe one. Take your wife to the Four Seasons. It's a beautiful thing. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it. Step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Look forward to speaking there tomorrow. Bam! Go get them, folks.